Fresh and Famous Radio. Fresh and Famous Radio, home of the fresh news, famous interviews, conquering the radio waves in the world. Right now, we have a model, actress, and she's on Nick Cannon's Wildin' Out. She's one of the girls on MTV. Fitness and nutrition enthusiast, Lolo, what's the deal?
What's up? How's it going?
Everything is good. I had to give you the smooth introduction. You know what I mean? It's a smooth night tonight. I'm feeling good. XO is feeling good. What's good with you?
I'm just chilling right now. Just chilling at home, relaxing. I just flew back from New York, so I'm kind of just getting back into chill mode right now. Not for long, though.
You're supposed to be. You got to be kind of warm, though, because I heard it's pretty chilly out there in the East Coast, in New York especially.
Oh, yeah, it was so cold. On the day we were flying back to California, I know mostly those planes were canceled. Their trips were just canceled. So luckily mine wasn't, though, but I was glad to get back to California.
Good. Yeah. Did you hear about that, XO? It's like nuts. Like, they're canceling flights like crazy.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I did hear a lot of flights getting canceled, not only from New York back to Cali, but also from Cali back to Indonesia. There was a volcano that erupted out there.
Damn. Oh, Lolo, who was the first person to ever call you Lolo?
I don't really know. Like, it was more just like a nickname, I think, that me and my friends just kind of came up with whenever we go out to, you know, like when you're in high school and you go out to parties, you want to have like a cool code name. So I would come up with different names. Like, sometimes mine would be Ray Ray, because my middle name is Racine. So I would just go by that sometimes. But I think Lolo just stuck with me. Like, that was the nickname that we just stuck with, and people call me that to this day.
That's so cute.
Did you have a nickname before Lolo? Like, you had Ray Ray. Was there any other ones you had?
Not really. Sometimes we would come up with, like, fake names.
just
to switch it up. Sometimes I go by L, just to make Lolo's a little different, so
That's what's up. How did you get the gig for Wildin' Out?
I was actually discovered on Instagram. Theo Wong she's a stylist, and she works for Incredible Entertainment, which is Nick Cannon's entertainment. So Theo Wong emailed my manager, Teresa Gilbreth, who's with Multifaceted Inc. Mm-hmm. She emailed her asking for me to come in for an interview for Wildin' Out. And I initially didn't know what it was for. It was just an interview, and then I got in and found out it was for Wildin' Out, and I met Nick Cannon and his people, and it was real cool. It was like a real chill environment. And that was how it happened.
That's crazy. So what exactly do you do for Wildin' Out now that you got the gig?
Well, we filmed all the episodes already, so they're going to be airing this summer. And what we had to do was, we just got our hair and makeup done, got some cute little outfits, and we're there to pump off the crowd, smile and wave, and it was so fun because I'm new to the entertainment industry, and so I think that being on Wildin' Out was a perfect starting point, you know, because it was just a great environment.
That's good for you. So Lolo, you know, The whole environment, you know what I mean? Because the energy we see on TV, it just seems so exciting. Like, what's it like from start to finish?
It's crazy because, like, you're on the show with comedians, so you're around funny, happy people. And so when, like, you feel that vibe, I just vibe right off it. And so I was even told on set, like, I didn't even imagine you'd be just goofy and silly. I'm like, I mean, I am goofy and silly, but when you're around other goofy, silly comedians, it just brings it out of you, so you can kind of, you know, just yourself. There's such a happy environment. It was just so fun. You meet great people, and then the stars that came for each episode, got to meet them, and, like, you see how people act growing up. You know, you just see them on TV, and then you finally get to meet them, and it was pretty cool.
Was entertainment something you always wanted to get into? I know you mentioned that, you know, you're new in the entertainment industry. Was it always something you wanted to get into? Did you ever see yourself on TV?
I always dreamed about it. You know, when you're a little girl, you're like, I want to be an actress. Like, that was me. So I went to an art school in high school, and I took acting classes, and I wanted to be an actress. And I've always loved the arts, though, like all kinds of arts. I like dancing, I like drawing and painting and ceramics. I was always into that throughout high school. So now that I'm finally able to get into it, it's just, it's like it's
feels right, but it feels surreal at the same time, because, you know, when you're working so hard to get somewhere and you finally are getting there, then it's amazing. It makes you appreciate it even more.
That's dope.
It does.
Dope. We got Lolo right here on Fresh and Famous Radio. Make sure you keep the chat room booming. Let us know how you like her. So Lolo, you know, you were also featured on Justin Bieber's Wait for a Minute featuring Tyga, right?
Right.
What was that like?
That was pretty fun. That one was, that was like my first real music video I did. So that was pretty fun. Like, I got to meet Tyga and Justin Bieber, and they introduced themselves on set. Like, right when they came in, they introduced themselves to everybody. I thought that was pretty cool, and just shows, like, you know, how humble, cool people they are. It was a fun video too. Like, we were running, and I just remember thinking not to fall the whole time.
That video was funny. That video was dope though. What was Bieber like?
Cool.
What was Bieber like? You know, kicking it with him.
He's just a normal 19-year-old kid. I think he's like 19 years old. He's a normal boy. Yeah. He's a little chill. He goofed around. He was joking, and it was fine though. They were both real cool vibes.
Yeah. So you said that being that video with just Bieber and Tyga was your first real music video. What was the first one you ever did?
I mean, I've done like local artist music videos. No one of, I haven't done anyone that was as famous as Justin Bieber. Like, I never thought I would meet him or Tyga, so it was pretty exciting.
Do you have, like, any, like, nieces or nephews that are, like, in love with Justin Bieber?
Yeah, I do, actually. My cousin, she loves Justin Bieber, so she texted me after, and she's like, I can't believe you met him. All my friends are jealous.
That's so cute. My little sisters are...
down the way, bye.
Everybody loves Bieber.
Yes, they do. Especially the little high schoolers. Oh, my goodness.
Everybody. Dudes change, though. That's crazy how we see it. You know what I mean? Like, how we see the growth, and for everybody, too, how everybody's growing. So, Lolo, you know, you're all about the fitness and nutrition. So, how do you stay in shape?
I spent a lot of time on bodybuilding.com just to, get knowledgeable about nutrition and workouts and stuff. So, I learned about my macros and how to count them and eat right. I eat really clean. Like, I eat probably about 5 servings of vegetables a day, so green vegetables. I try to limit my carbs. And then for working out, I implement different forms of cardio and weightlifting. So one day I'll run, like, 3 miles. Another day I'll do sprints for a mile. And then I'll do heavy weightlifting and heavy squats and deadlifts. You just switch it up. It's fun. The thing that I have the most challenge with is probably, like, the high-intensity interval training, the HIIT training. That stuff is hard.
Yeah. It's hard for me to do sit-ups, so you're on a roll.
I heard it takes like about 3 weeks to get in the habit of doing something. So once you stick to a gym plan or some kind of workout plan for 3 weeks, I mean, it's mostly like just a habit you got going on.
Oh, yeah. It's easy to fall out, too, especially with traveling. It's easy because you don't have a gym at hand right away, so you're kind of like, well, if I don't have a gym, I'm just not going to work out. And so I'll just be like, oh, I'm just going to eat right. That'll make up for it, but... It is easy to fall out, and I have to admit that I did fall out when I was in New York, so we're going to get back to that
track. Lolo. I'm telling.
So you were in New York for Valentine's. How was your Valentine's?
I spent it on an airplane, so the ladies I was sitting next to, those are my Valentine's. But it was cool. I slept most of it on the plane. I just knocked right out. And when I got back to California, me and my mom went out to dinner, so it was pretty cool.
I guess that's something all the guy listeners are smiling about, that you were on the plane with 3 women for Valentine's Day. What's
all the men out there are like, oh man, I wanted to go out with her.
Right. Keep that chat room booming. Let us know what's going on. So, Lolo, what's your ethnicity?
My ethnicity is, I'm a mix. My dad, he's Caucasian. He's from Irish, Scottish, English, like the European mix. My mom is French, Black, she's from the West Indies and also East Indian.
That's what's up.
Beautiful mix.
Yeah, I'm pretty much, I'm very mixed. I have a lot of ethnicity.
Lolo, you are doing your thing. We can't wait to see you on Wild and Out season 6, right?
Yes,
thank you. Yeah, season 6.
Season six. See, what can we expect from this? Yo, you got to give us like a sneak. We can't get a hold of Nick Cannon, so we got you to tell us like what's going on for this
it's
season.
It's gonna be great. No, I was crying almost every episode. Like, oh my god, my eyeliner smudging. I'm like, I was scared of smudging because I was crying.
That's got to be intense though. Like, you got to like put something on, like some kind of special makeup on to like keep it from like crying and sweating, because it seems like so extreme in there. Like, anything goes down.
Yeah, no, that's really how it is. Like, Lolo Wood, one of the comedians on the show, he did his 30-second stand-up, and he called me up unexpectedly for his stand-up. He sang a song to me, like, serenaded me. It was hilarious. It was, you know, it's just, you never know what's going to happen. It's all unexpected. It's fun times, and the comedians, like, the cast that they cast in this first season are hilarious. You got
people.
Do we have anybody new on the cast of Wild N Out?
Oh, yeah, there's a few new people. Like, there's some people, like King Bash from Vine, he's new.
Okay.
There's a few other people. I don't really know who was on the other seasons, like, consistently, but I know that there was a lot of new people on this season, too.
Yeah, well, King Bash is super hilarious. I watch all his Vines.
Vine started blowing. Do you do Vine, Lolo?
No, I don't do Vines. I actually have a Vine, and I just watch people's Vines from it. I don't post.
You're just
Vines,
like me.
Basically.
You're exactly like me. Lolo,
so out of all the social networks and Twitter and all that, what's your best one for everyone to contact you on?
Probably Instagram. That's the one I had for a while, just Instagram, and then I recently made a Twitter.
That's how she got heard. That's how she got discovered.
Yeah.
Of course, Instagram.
Let the fans know what her Instagram is.
Okay, my Instagram is at Lolo Doom, and I just made a Twitter. You can follow my Twitter at Lolo Doom _ because Lolo Doom was already taken for some reason. But
don't you hate that shit? I'll be trying to deck the person who takes my Twitter name.
No bueno.
Lolo Doom. Follow her on Instagram and Twitter. Lolo Doom with the _. Fresh and Famous Radio. Keep the chat room booming. We're going to spend some music. Lolo, what song do you want to hear, boo?
Let's hear Wait For a Minute by Tyga featuring Justin Bieber.